charges after a number of alleged incidents in St. Catharines. Niagara Regional Police say they were called to a local community center on Monday evening, where witnesses told them a man had approached a 10-year-old boy and started speaking with him. When confronted by the child's mother, who was carrying her 6-year-old son, the man allegedly made contact with the younger boy. The same man is believed to have then approached a group of kids playing in a nearby schoolyard and briefly entered the school itself. He's now charged with invitation to sexual touching, assault, and 2 counts of breaching probation. Let's look at local news from CBC Toronto. More news coming up at the top of the hour. Here's the weather forecast for Toronto, Hamilton, and Niagara. Increasing cloudiness early this afternoon with a high of 16 degrees today. The UV index will be high. Tonight, mainly cloudy with a 60% chance of showers, low of 12 degrees. For Friday, mainly cloudy with a chance of showers early in the morning, clearing later on, high of 18. For Peterborough, the north is increasing cloudiness this afternoon, high of 16 degrees. Tonight, mainly cloudy, a few showers and a low of 8. For Friday, showers ending in the morning, then clear, high of 19.
A mariachi suit with a face painted in sugar skull makeup, all while singing songs about life and death and the world in between. For Jorge, growing up as a kid in Mexico, talking about death was normal.
Whenever we talked about somebody who was dead, we tried to remember the positives. Sometimes my grandpa would make like really crass jokes about somebody who had died, and nobody would be horrified about it, or, you know, like, oh yeah, that your uncle blah blah blah, he was such an idiot. And then people would laugh, and they were still being playful, they were still being loving with a place, a person that they would have been loving with. In Mexico, we have this very intricate, we go to the funeral, we cry, we leave flowers, we bury our dead. But we also have the Day of the Dead, where we celebrate their lives by putting an altar up for them, by dusting off their photos and putting them up for us to see, and by, you know, playing the music that they like and eating the food that they like, and you remember the time that you had with them and experiencing it in a tangible, beautiful way.
Just last year, Jorge's lessons on death were put to the test when his father died suddenly by suicide.
I was thoroughly unprepared for the death of my father. When I heard about my father's passing, it was like the ending of a period in my life where I felt like I had a voice.